Okay, on the ball nuts here, I'm gonna be putting push connect fitting here. This is for the X axis, actually. Yeah, it fits in here like this, and I'll basically be having the fitting coming out like that. It's to oil up the ball screw. The Y axis can be pretty easy. It's basically going to be going down like this, actually be coming out like that, and it'll just be having a line going, and it'll drip straight down onto the ball screw to provide the oiling on the X axis. I'm going to drill it in through the side, but basically, you know, pump oil into it. It's just going to roll out the end of the ball nut mount and not get onto the ball screw. So I tried a couple different things to make a seal for the end. First one was just using hot glue. This is just a scrap piece of ball screw, the same thing. It's the same ball nut mount, and I got an old ball nut on there just to have a depth stop, basically. First try with the hot glue gun, squirted as much as I could down around the inside. Problem is, it dries so quick. Came out a little funky. I don't think it'd seal very well. Could clean it up. Might still work. Made another one out of silicone. Squirted a bunch of silicone and packed it in there. It's just your basic, clear RTV silicone. Left it in there overnight. Let it dry up, pull it out of there, and it fits the threads real nice, and it seems to be a lot better, did a lot better job of sealing against the screw, so it should work. Already had a void, so that's just fine. I just need a little bit on the end to seal up the end, and I'll cut out this part so that the hole going in through will have some place for the oil to go. And that way it should put oil around the ball screw and keep it from leaking out. And it'll just fit right on the end, and it'll be able to seal against the ball screw and keep the oil in there. And it's starting to go together. Got the Y-axis ball nut mounted up. Did some powder coating on my CNC conversion parts to make them look better. Well, I'll make a note on this front oil port. I just used the top as actually one of the two mounting holes for that center indicator. I just drilled it out the tap for the 1/8-27. It's just a little too high to really use. The threads broke through a little bit, and I had to file these down and hit them with a diamond file to make sure everything's nice and flat here, because otherwise you'd have a bump there and the table wouldn't exactly fit very good on there. So if you're going to do this, I'd maybe drill another new hole, actually about maybe 300 thousandths down from the top, maybe about 1/4 inch over from one side or the other. This is dead center, but a little, it could be off 1/4, 1/2 inch, ain't gonna hurt nothing. That's what I would do. If it's gonna do it again, off to one side, down about 300 thousandths, you'd be good to go. That's the distance I made the ones for the Y-axis, and made them 300 thousandths up from the bottom of the saddle, and you got plenty of room in there. The dovetails are actually about 600 thousandths, maybe 5/8 thick, so about 300 thousandths puts them right in the middle. Good. I also notice I took my grinder and flattened off the end of this dovetail. Is tapered like that one was, and made a little more square, because otherwise the fitting was going to bump into it. Wouldn't go deep enough. Ground that out of the way. Okay, this the rear of the saddle is the only place where you really had to drill do much drilling. I drilled a 1/8 hole, you know, from the edge all the way to the center of the saddle. Then I drilled a 1/8 hole into the back all the way through, so it comes out the dovetail. That'll oil the dovetail. Then I drilled down from the top to intersect it, cleaned them all out. So then we need to just tap the hole in the back here, 832, and put a little 832 set screw in there, and as you can see, I Loctited it. So we need the back of this flush, because it can actually bump up against the column. So there we go. Now we got that oiled, and there's nothing interfering with it getting its full travel. The other holes work the same way. This, I just put a hole in the center of the side here. It went in through the gib strip. I think I showed it in the pictures. It just, when I first drilled it, just to make a mark in the gib strip. I took the gib strip out, and I actually drilled about a 1/4-inch hole through the gib strip and deburred it real good. You put it back in once you clean everything up. That way, if you need to adjust it here or there, you got plenty of room to adjust it, and you'll still be able to get all oil through the gib strip onto the actual gib. And of course, you know, drill the hole down. I don't think you can see it in there, but it's the same way on the top here. Drill a hole down through the center so it intersects the hole, so it's lubricating the dovetail, or the bed rather. And you can see where that's the actual original hole that was in there. Same thing, you drill down through the top so the oil shall come up, go into our grooves we made a long time ago. Keep that all oiled. The other side, exact same as this, just a hole in the center, and it actually just goes in through the dovetail. It's like the one in the back here. There's no gib strip. It's the same thing on the front here. Where is my gib strip? There it is. Here's my gib strip. See, I got a 1/4-inch hole. No location. I drilled the hole, marker hole in there while it was still assembled, so I know where it should be approximately whenever it's put back together. 1/8-inch hole or 1/4-inch hole just gives me more room for adjustment down the road. Still be able to get oil in through there. Well, that's the problem, ain't it? That's gonna have to be made to go lower. That's gonna drop down at least 1/4-inch. Maybe go 3/8 just to be safe. Figure out how to make that lower. Looks like we got maybe 3/4 inch above the gap between the saddle and the bottom of the table, maybe 13/16 to max, 3/4 to play it safe. All right, putting the getting one of these to fit under there just isn't going to work. How about trying to cut this down farther? But then there's no way you're going to be able to tighten that on there. It's going to blow it all out of shape. Get oil down there. Only thing it's really doing is, anyhow, is providing a little path to drip oil down on top of the ball screw. It's not actually going into the ball nut. So my workaround for that is to just use a hole that's already going down directly over top of the ball screw. This is, as you're looking from the front, it's our oil hole for the rear. So I'm going to drill a little 16th inch diameter hole down through the existing 8th inch hole I have there. I want it smaller so that otherwise, you know, you pump oil through here, it's going to go the easiest way, which would have been straight down. So that's why I make it a lot smaller diameter. Will be enough restriction to allow oil to still come up and out the side and out through the top to oil the dovetails, but it'll still allow enough oil to drip down directly onto the ball screw. So that'll oil our Y-axis ball screw. All right, one last thing I did here on the two dovetails that are just the dovetails, they don't have the gib strip in them. I took my disc grinder and carefully went in and just ground a little slit right where the oil hole comes out. That'll just give it a little bit of a pocket for the oil to collect instead of just coming straight out. Nothing real deep, it's maybe 30 thousandths deep, just a little slit. Alright, here's the X-axis ball nut mount. Got my little silicone seal I made. So I cut out a little notch, about half of it. So it'll fit right in there. Oil can go into that little pocket and get right to the ball screw in there. See, it just pushes right in there. Put a little oil around there, and then the ball screw should slide right through there. Alright, we got the inside good, but that's going to hit right there. It's flexible, can push it out of the way, but back and forth, that would just rub right through that. It's plastic. So I think we'll have to make us a little manifold to go down here, and I can have the hoses come down into it. Be a little neater looking. That's one way to hook it up. It's a little clear. Get the one line to go out that way. Could shorten these up, tighten it up a little bit. We'll see.